Okay, hi. I want to show you how to make a Mother's Day DIY gift box, an alphabet box. So the first thing you need to do is you need to get your straw board or any hard material that you can use. Okay, have your pair of scissors, have your cutter knife, and you have your glue. Okay, so what I did was I cut out the alphabet M, which stands for mom. Okay, already. And then these ones are actually supposed to sit right at the sides, like here and here, and all these spaces. So these designs will go around the alphabet. Okay, so which is what I have right here. Okay, so the next thing I need to do is I'm gonna take my crepe paper and I'm going to cover up all these. Okay, so I've covered up all the sides that I'm using to build the box, and this is what is left. So I'm placing it right on top of my crepe paper roll and applying glue. So I'm just basically okay, so it's completely covered in front and the back. So now we have to use our glue and glue this to the sides. So this will so you have to hold it until it dries out. So I'm just going to hold it for a little bit for it to dry out. Then you do the same thing here, 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 here. Okay. So this will be here. And I'm going to do the same thing all over. Okay, as a continuation to our box set, to our mother's box, I'm going to be using this cardstock, pattern cardstock. So I'll be using this, too, to make the cover. Okay. So the whole idea is, I'm going to show you what I need to do. Okay, so I would have preferred a longer cardstock, but I can't seem to get that. So I'm just going to piece these two together. Like, I'm going to glue them together. So it's long enough for what I want to use it for. So I'm just applying glue here. Applying glue here, just to the edge. I would have preferred one long cast stock, but I can't. I don't have that right now, so I'm making use of what I have. So I'm just going to place this right here. So it's one now, long enough for what I want to use it for. Okay, so this is my alphabet box sitting on my cardstock. So you have to ensure that it's long enough to cover the box, okay? And then I'm just gonna take out the measurement for this so I can know where to fold. So this is our alphabet box size. So okay, so I'm just gonna line the sides. So remember, we put our alphabet box on the cardstock, so we can take out the measurement of, can know the exact measurement. So this is the size of the card. This is the size. Let me place this here so you can see. So if you place this here, you place this here, the lines at the sides are just slightly bigger than the alphabet box, just slightly bigger, nothing more, on both sides. So you can see just a little, like 1/4 inch on both sides. Okay, this is my box, it's my alphabet box. So I want the cover to come slightly up this way. So to get that measurement, I'm just going to place this here, and I'm just placing this here and taking the measurement with my pencil. Okay, so I'm just going to take out this side. I'm going to cut out this part. Cut out this part. So I'm just going to show you what I'm going to do here. I'm basically going to use my bone folder and score along the line. So I'm just scoring along this line. Okay, so I'm going to use this bone folder and score along every pencil mark. Okay, so my box can fold easily. Okay, so basically what I did, instead of cutting out the excesses, I folded them in. Okay. So I'm just going to apply glue here. Doing the same thing right here. So this will sit right here, and this will sit right here. Thank you. same thing.